mRNA. What are the key components of mRNA having means? When you see the structure of RNA, it have various components. So one is cap, so non-coding region 1. Next, initiation codon, initiation codon. Next, coding region, and then non-coding region 2, and polyadenine tile. Polyadenine tile. So these are the key components of mRNA, messenger RNA. Messenger RNA 2 to 3% of total RNA it occupies. So at the 5' end it have the cap. So what is the function of cap? What is cap? Cap is nothing but of 5-methyl guanine triphosphate. So that is called as cap. So after formation of the mRNA, it goes to the RNA processing. The first step of the RNA processing is capping. Capping means making of or adding of 5-methylguanine triphosphate at 5' end. That is cap. Why it is compulsory, why it is needed means the cap, without cap the mRNA is unstable, and the cap promotes the joining towards the ribosomal site. Okay, and non-coding region 1. So non-coding region 1 means it approximately 100 to 200 base pairs of length, here no work. And initiation codon, initiation codon means it is AUG, here the protein synthesis is initiated. And coding region approximately 1600 to 2000 base pairs of the length, and here the protein synthesis is proceed. And NC, non-coding region also present, is approximately 100 base pair to 150 base pairs of length. And at last, polyadenine tail, so it is present in the 3' end. So what is polyadenine means? After the formation of the mRNA during the transcription, so here after the capping, polyadenylation is happened. So it means joining of poly A's. Many A's are joined here to maintain stability of mRNA. So this is the mRNA. And you come to the tRNA. The tRNA is tRNA. tRNA is transfer RNA, also called as adapter RNA. Adapter RNA. So the model or structure of the tRNA is clover leaf model. Clover leaf model. So it is proposed by the scientist Hawley et al. So how the structure is means, you see here. So this is the amino acid binding arm, binding site. So also called amino acid binding arm. So this is T-C arm. So it is useful for ribosome binding site. It is also called as ribosome binding site. So it is variable arm, variable arm. And it is anticodon arm, anticodon arm. So anticodons are present here. So for example, anticodon CCC is present. CCC is present means it screen the mRNA, it search on the mRNA GGG. Okay, So you see in the mRNA the codons are present, but whereas in tRNA they are anti-codon. So both are complementary to each other. And here D arm also present, DHU arm also we said as D hydroxy uracil arm, also called as aminoacyl synthetase arm, aminoacyl synthetase arm. So like many arms are present here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 arms are present here. The first arm is aminoacyl binding site arm. Here the amino acids are having the site to bind. And here the ribosome is binded here. The anticodons are present here. And here aminoacyl synthetase is present here. This is the tRNA. But you come to the rRNA. The rRNA can occupy the 80% of the tRNA. But it is in linear form. Most of the organism, it is stable, and also here two types. It means it involve in the ribosomes. The ribosomes are two types, again 70S ribosomes and 80S ribosomes. Again they have the subunits of 30S and 50S subunits, whereas here 40S and 60S subunits. Okay, but sometimes they are, when they are in linear, they are what is coiled like. Coiled means the pairing is happened here. When the pairing is happened, they become inactive. So unpaired segments of the rRNA only active, paired segments of the rRNA are inactive. So this is the rRNA is involved in the translation. So these are the three types of the RNAs, mRNA, tRNA and rRNA. How they are involved in the protein synthesis, we continue.